spending a lot of money, there are plenty of reasons to stress, and there are plenty of things that can go wrong, but there are plenty of things you can do to keep that from happening. Joining us now is Lawyers.com editor-in-chief Larry Bodine. Good morning to you, Larry.
Well, good morning to you. How are you today?
I'm doing great. It seems like in this day and age of instant access to the internet, you can find out anything about a company. Do you find that to be true in the world of moving companies as well?
Yes, that's true. You can find a lot of online reviews about moving companies, but the mistake that you want to avoid is to hire a mover over the internet. A lot of dishonest movers will offer you a quote over the telephone or over the internet without visiting your property, and that sets you up for falling victim to a very common scam. So my advice is always get a written estimate for the move based on a visit to your property.
Okay, so if you find them on the, let me interrupt you real quick. If you find them on the internet, you need to say, I want you to please come out to my home and give me that written estimate. Don't just, you know, say click here and then they come over eventually and move you.
That's right, because well, the mover will say how many rooms and he'll estimate and just give you a ballpark figure.
Okay, good to know. So what happens? I mean, inevitably, it seems like something's going to get damaged. I mean, it's kind of just the nature of the beast. What do you do if your items are damaged? How do you seek any recourse?
Well, if you're dealing with an honest mover, they're going to build the cost of insurance into the price of the move, and it's going to be a simple matter of just filing a claim form, and you can get your repair or you can get your property replaced. Unfortunately, if you're working with a dishonest mover and someone who doesn't have insurance, you're going to have to file a claim in small claims court or the trial court and see if you can't get a recovery to cover the damage to your property.
And we know most people probably won't do that, so they'll just take the loss. So do you think you should take out insurance when you're planning a move, and who do you take it out with?
Well, you should definitely get insurance. If the mover itself does not offer insurance, then you should get a zero deductible property damage insurance policy. You can get this through your homeowner policy, and in fact, you can even get moving insurance online on the internet for $125.
And you believe it's worth it then. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about leaving the home that you're currently in and your landlord. Is it legal to break a lease? At what point can you do that? Or should you not do it at all, Larry?
Well, it is legal to break a lease, but the downside is that you as the tenant are going to be responsible for all the following rent payments. And what you can do, if the landlord is flexible, is to try to find a substitute tenant who will take over the balance of the rental payments. This is something I've done in my own experience, and you know, it worked well because, you know, I'm a trained lawyer, and I was able to persuade the landlord.
Yeah, it may not work so well with the other with the rest of us. And what about if your previous landlord will not get you your safety give you your safety deposit? I mean, you've got to leave it in condition that you found it, don't you, as a tenant?
Well, that's true, and you're entitled to get your deposit back, but I'm sorry to say that it's very common for the landlord to hold on to the security deposit. What I've had to do in more than one situation was take the landlord to court in small claims, and I successfully recovered my security deposit and got back insurance to boot. And that was because I checked there was a local town ordinance, and these exist in many cities, mm-hmm. that create a bunch of tenants' rights provisions, and it makes it a lot easier for you to get your deposit back.
Yeah, that's actually a very good idea to plant in everybody's mind, because not only does the state of Florida here have rules listing what you can and can't get back, but the city does as well, and you can find that on coj.net. Larry Bodine, if only we could have you advocating for all people suffering losses as a result of a move. Thanks so much for joining us.
It was my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
7:49 now. Richard Nunn standing by. What kind of Wednesday's on tap for us, Rich?
Got a good looking Wednesday, just a little minor issue.